I'd like to tell you about a really big problem one of my clients had, where the solution ended up being quite simple and affordable. So every so often a big thunderstorm would roll by, and somehow lightning would get into the coaxial line that fed their cable modem. Normally the modem would get zapped, and sometimes the lightning surge would go beyond that and it would fry their router or their switch, or even worse, their computers, their phones, and one time it even got into their server. So that's really bad. I've tried lightning arresters, I've tried all kinds of things with the backup battery, the UPS coaxial protection in between, and somehow it just seems to make its way through. So that being said, I had to come up with a solution. So my first thought was, let's turn that connection into a beam of light that energy can't pass through. So to do that, of course, we have fiber optics. So I haven't really worked much with fiber before, but I looked it up real quick and studied it, and it's really not that difficult. Right now the client has a 24-port gigabit switch, and there are either Cat5e or Cat6 patch cables that run out to the rest of the network. The cable modem is also connected to the switch with a Cat5e patch cable, and that's the source of where the problem lies. So our way around this is to introduce a fiber optic cable that sits between the cable modem and the network switch. That will convert the signal from the cable modem into a beam of light that cannot carry lightning or the energy associated with it, and then we need to pipe it back into the network so it can be used and accessed directly through without the risk of lightning damage. So what I found when I researched this is this TP-Link Gigabit Ethernet Media Converter. Hold up, don't buy that. This is me from the future, just letting you know I did run into some problems with the TP-Link media converter. It turns out it's only a $21 box, and I just got excited I found something that would work. But when I was on site, I had packet loss issues, and their VOIP phones would just randomly go offline, and just weird things were happening. So what I did was I ordered a 6-port switch that had one SFP port, and it was about $80, so that's a much better quality, more expensive product. And when I installed it with that, everything worked great. So now back to the video. So its job is to basically allow you to plug a Cat5e, Cat6 cable in here, and then it has what's called an SFP port, which is small form factor pluggable. And with those, you can actually buy whatever you need. One end plugs into the little media adapter, and the other end can be whatever you want it to be. It can be Cat6 or Cat anything, or fiber, or you name it. As long as you can find it, it'll slide right in, and then this box will be able to convert from one to the other. So that seems quite simple. We'll take our SFP adapter and plug it into the media converter, and then get a hold of our fiber optic cable and fit that into the SFP, and looks like we're ready to connect to a switch. Before I install this equipment at my client's office, I'd like to test it out in a lab environment first, just to make sure everything's going to work well. So in the back here, we have a cable modem, and it has a yellow Cat5e cable that runs over to here, and this is a line that we need to intercept and protect. So I'm going to plug that line into our media converter, which then converts it to a fiber optic cable. And then I have another SFP that I purchased that'll go right into their gigabit switch once I install it in this adapter here. So we'll go ahead and connect that. And then this adds the capability of fiber to this network switch. So we'll slide that in here. And I do see that the link lights lit up. So these two are now communicating. The main switch is receiving the signal from the cable modem, and everything should be online and protected. So I'll go back over to the computer and we'll do a speed test just to make sure that the optimal speed is making it through the fiber setup. Now I'm back at the computer and we're connected to the cable modem service through that fiber optic cable. So let's see how our speeds are doing. My internet service is 500, and sometimes they give you a little bit more. So as you can see, we're well over 500 running through the fiber optic setup that I showed you earlier. So I'll call this a success. So we are now fiber optic, and there's no way that the cable modem can zap the rest of the network. Of course, when I install this at my client's office, I won't physically have the media adapter touching the switch because there's an opportunity for electricity to transfer between the two cases. So I'll do everything smartly over there, and hopefully that'll be the end of their problems. If you really enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel, and I plan on making many more in the near future. Thanks so much, and have an awesome day.